Okay, thank you everyone for joining this session. The goal of this session is devotees take control of their own lives, financial management. Of course, I go beyond financial management. Financial management is only one part of it, because for our life, it is not just financial management, it is our consciousness management. So that is very important. So this is the season of Baisakhi, where everybody should be happy. Springtime, sun is coming out, but of course there is looming threat of the virus on our heads. So let me go to the first slide. These are called Radhika's principles of survival. This is what I have been applying after experience in America for 25 years. This is my 26th year in America. So number one is, you should always keep 1 year savings in America, because everything looks rosy. The roads are nice. Your car is very smooth. Everybody's so nice when you go to a grocery store. How are you? This and that. But when bad times come in America, they really come. Like I remember when I was in, I first moved to United States in 1994, we were just coming off of a recession. And you know how people were living? Two families to a two-bedroom home, because they could not afford individual rent, because the recession was so bad that rent back then was like $600 to $800 for a two-bedroom apartment. So one family could not afford $600 rent by themselves. Indian families were in very, very bad situation back then. Now, last 11 years, we have seen a continuous boom, but this is not typical of America, right? Thank you. Yeah, so what you are seeing right now is not typical of America. Like when I came, the average Indian family used to make $40,000 a year. And if you pay more than $600 for your apartment rent, people would think that you are crazy. Salaries were very low. Income, people used to be very, very careful. We used to go to grocery shops and buy only things that are on sale. We rarely bought anything for full price, because we didn't have that much money back then, 1994. So based on that experience, I find that you should always have 1 year savings. Otherwise, you'll pretty much have to pack your bags and go back to wherever, you know, we came from. So 1 year savings is always a must in this country, because when bad times come, they come with a big thunder. Second thing is, you should know where your money is. Consolidate savings in one place. So right now, if you put your money in Chase or Bank of America, they'll give you 0.05% interest. But there are online banks like Synchrony and Ally.com, which give you 1% interest. That is better than nothing, right? So for 3 years, we used to have Northwest Share money in Bank of America. And in 3 years, we got $15 interest. Then I moved to HSBC. And in 3 months, I got $800 interest on Northwest Share's money, right? Northwest Share is the holding corporation for Synergy Learning Academy, Vedic Museum, which is the cow farms, the two farms that we have, Mana Samskriti, which is the Telugu language classes, Washington Helping Hands, which is like a charity that Lavanya Reddy runs. Of course, the free food truck also comes under Northwest Share. So even 1% sometimes is a pretty good amount, actually. It's not a small amount. So we should always keep money in interest-bearing online accounts. So in America, your money is guaranteed up to $250,000 in what is known as Federal Depository Insurance, FDIC. So it is better to keep it wherever you are getting. Even small interest is a good thing. Otherwise, it will be a challenge for you. Next thing is, go low on stocks. So the golden era of stocks is behind us. And I have a slide on that one. We'll come to that. So don't think the stocks will always go up. Last 11 years is a unusual thing in the history of America. In America, typically, for 7 years, stocks will go up. For 5 years, they'll go down. Again, 7 years, they'll go up. Again, 5 years, they'll go down. But this has been unusual because of a lot of technology-driven growth. We have not seen a recession. After 7 years, technically, there should be a recession in America. But now recession is happening. Now recession, a pretty bad recession is happening. My brother works for Regions Bank, and they are talking about it will take 5 years to recover from this current downturn, because current downturn has killed a lot of supply chains. Like I went and I wanted to buy one monitor on Amazon.com, good priced. I put it in my cart. Next day I came, sold out. And when it will be replenished, who knows? Because China factories are shut down. So supply chains have seriously broken. The next best thing to do is buying land. Because what's happening is arable land means where you can grow crops that is coming down worldwide. Like if you want to buy land in Guntur, 1 acre is 3 crore rupees. That is $450,000, 1 acre in Guntur. Can you believe it? So land is getting, because population is increasing, land is becoming less and less. So if you don't have land, and if the supply chains are broken, what will you eat? That's the question, right? So we need to plan for that eventuality. Because, you know, one of my Microsoft colleagues, he bought 5 acres land in somewhere between Kent and Enumclaw. And I asked him, why do you do it? He says, yes, if you want to survive, you need to have land. Because tomorrow, if there's a war, he didn't say corona because he didn't know that virus can be so deadly. If there is a war, what will you eat? Costco supply will cut off. Safeway and QFC will cut off. So if you want to stay alive, you need to have your own land. Otherwise, we'll be in big time trouble. Next point is, in Enumclaw and Auburn, retirees are selling land, right? So it is good to kind of lock in the land right now. If you want to stay in America, and I don't think any one of you is going to India. I also have a slide on that one. This is our dream, right? Oh, someday we'll go to India. Actually, reality is, I've seen the previous generation. Most Indians who came to America are dying here. They are not actually going back to India because you'll not fit there. That is the reality. If we can just keep that hope, oh, someday I'll go back, but you know, it's not going to happen. So now we have to, this is our country. So we have to figure out what we will do in this country, not in some far off land. India is a foreign country to us now. So we should buy land here and then be prepared, right? Otherwise, how are we going to eat? As it is, a lot of products are not available. Like, you know, we used to get bendi, a little expensive, $3.99, $4.29 per pound. But now you're not even getting that. Supply is cut off, right? The other point is cut down on expenses. We have become very habituated to spending so much. Like right now, I see everybody around me. People are buying Teslas. People are buying, you know, expensive things for their home, devotees and non-devotees. But this was not like this case when I came to America. Like people were extremely careful because you are in a foreign land. One small mistake, who knows what will happen? You don't want to kind of be neither here nor there, right? So cutting down expenses and keeping 1 year savings is very, very important. Otherwise, we'll be in trouble. Actually, that's what happened to Venkat and Prabhu, right? He bought a home for 600,000. And in the last downtown, 2008, 2009, it came to 420. So he did a short sale for 420 and he left. Of course, a different matter that now the price has gone up. But what if economy didn't recover, right? So to make $180,000 in America, you have to work for 6 years. You can have maximum $30,000 savings per year, maximum. And you know this, I don't need to tell you. So cutting down on expenses and being very careful is very important. The other point is we have to help each other devotees progress spiritually. Because later on when we are down, they'll come and lift us up. You cannot think that I am doing so good. Guru Maharaj said 16 rounds, I am doing 18 rounds. So I'm already up there. The helicopter will come and take me to Goloka. So we are all thinking like that, but that's not true. Because I have seen so many people in our own temple who have fallen down, like who have gone away, right? They were good devotees and they are no longer to be seen. Not even once in a while you see them in QFC or something like that. But you know, so that is very much bound to happen. And most importantly, chant intensely. Rake Krishna Mareke, Mare Krishna Rakeke. If Krishna wants to kill you, he'll finish you. If he wants to save you, he will save you. So ultimately, Corona cannot touch you, Trump cannot touch you, anybody cannot touch you. If Krishna is supporting you, then nobody can touch you. Like yesterday, my wife was listening to one of the video where Bhakti Charu Maharaj was saying, ISKCON has 1 million people worldwide and we only have 5 deaths and 97 people in hospital. So what is special about us? Because we take shelter of Krishna. Right? So when we take shelter of Krishna, many things don't happen to us. Some things will still happen. There will always be tests. But many things that will happen to general population will not happen to us. So those are my Radhika Gopinath Das principle for survival. And you may have other ideas too. But this is what I've seen in 26 years of me being in America. Right? So I'm very careful. I mean, I will never buy a Tesla. I will never buy a big home. Because what happens is, if tomorrow Amazon balance is lost and people who bought Highcroft homes for 1.2 million, monthly payment is like $8,000. So if you don't have job for 6 months, 8 times 6, $48,000 you have to pay, right? So where will you get that $48,000 from? Because when economy is down, stocks are also down. So you cannot sell your 401k. So what will you do? Or you have to sell your 401k for one third the price, like some people have done. I know there was one couple here, market tanked in 2009, H1B didn't get renewed. They had to sell everything and leave within a week to their home country, India. Of course, he's now taken shelter of Ramnath Maharaj and he's doing pretty well in India. He started his own company, different issue, but he's no longer here. He's kicked out of America, right? So unless you plan for it, don't think life is rosy. Actually, life is not rosy in America. It appears like that. This is also one more trick of Maya. Makes you think that everything is good here. It's not actually. It's not. So any questions on principles for survival? Any additions? If you have any additions, I can add it to this slide.
So Prabhu, if this is the syllabus, I had like 2-3 points to add.
Yeah.
Just my own research, basically. So one is, and I'm speaking because I'm doing it. One is to create a will that includes things like, say this is a pandemic, right? If none of the family members survive, what will happen to the wealth? Mm-hmm. And one good option or easy option is that you write it down in the temple's name so that, your whole life becomes a life of akarma because every penny you struggled for is now pure akarma. So that's one. But apart from that, people may not be wanting to do that fully or partially. Then at least they should do the will in such a way that the property doesn't become government property and it goes to their larger family or wherever they want it to go.
That's a very good point. Actually, that's a separate bullet in itself. If you do not have a will, state of Washington is a very unique state. It's not a Republican state. It's a democratic state. Your property goes immediately. Yeah. It has happened to people.
Right. So that's one item. The second item is, Prabhu, when the property prices are high, like the situation now, they have still not dropped. Okay.
Right.
But we know we are heading for a dark tunnel, we do not know the light at the end of it.
Correct.
So doing a good HELOC in a place like BECU and having access to the cash in the equity of your home allows you to quickly pull money to use it for survival if you have to. But at least, you know, you're not kind of running out of cash while your stocks are down and 401k cannot be sold and jobs are not available and now you are out of the house, right?
Yeah.
So access to HELOC is a very powerful idea.
Question,
share additional point.
So that was second. And the third item is, Prabhu, we have this jobs group and it has its own effectiveness. My suggestion is we should have a VCC group on the LinkedIn where we all volunteers and devotees join in such a way that change of job becomes a cakewalk rather than a struggle.
That's a wonderful idea, Prabhuji. This is on LinkedIn. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. These were the 3 points I wanted to add.
I have one quick clarification, Prabhuji.
Recently,
I've been doing the research on the will. I heard particularly in Washington, even if there is no will, the property goes to the immediate blood relation, maybe the child immediate. Is that
we have to get clarification on that, because when I was working in Microsoft, the lawyers there or the lawyers assigned by Microsoft for this purpose, they were saying always have a will. It is dangerous not to have a will in Washington.
Okay.
So Prabhu, in will also there are two aspects. One is taking care of the property and second is taking care of the kids. So I think
children, yeah.
That second option, second aspect is more important.
Correct.
My point.
Yeah, children's custody, especially if they are under whatever 16 or 18. I do not know what is the age to call yourself self-sufficient here. Or an adult who can make decisions on property and your own life. But yeah, Ramakum Prabhu said a good point that we should have will for that also, and maybe will for the living will, which is like how things will be handled if you are in a coma for 6 months. Do you want your family to pay for your ICU and go bankrupt? So we should have a will around that also. Coming back to the second point, which Ramakum Prabhu mentioned, which is about kids. We should have like families making a treaty amongst themselves, like two families saying that we'll watch out for your kids and you watch out for our kids if something goes wrong. And our expectations like this, you know, our Indian family will come and take them, but or you deliver them there or something. But go through the whole conversation and be ready for all scenarios so that it does not become, see, ultimately from my point of view, and also life insurance is another thing. We should have strong life insurance. And the purpose of doing all this, like you mentioned, Prabhu, initially was it's the conscious management. Now, when does the conscious matter the most? At the point of dying. So if at the point of dying, you know that I have solid insurance that will give solid financial backup to my family. My kids are taken care of in such a way that they will go to larger family. And really, nobody depends on me. It's easier to think of Krishna. So for our own selfish, smooth exit, we should have all the good planning in place.
That's a good point. So, good life insurance, right?
And not the one that companies provide, because the job may not exist. What to do with that insurance?
Actually, company life insurance is a joke, because tomorrow they can lay you off with two weeks salary. And then what happens to your life insurance? That's why I don't take through my company. I have my own separate life insurance through MetLife.
Yes.
Okay. Anybody else? I know several people joined. Jaypal, Meenal, Satvika. Who is Satvika?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, this is Nityananda Vilas Das Gupta.
Okay. Good. Your daughter's name, okay. That's good. I want to make sure, right? So that our meeting doesn't get hijacked.
So Prabhu, I have one point. It is not necessarily related to this current situation. but planning for kids education.
Like, oh, I'm coming to that. There's a complete slide on that.
Okay, so if you want to go there.
I have anticipated every one of your questions because I have some questions.
Thank you.
I'm a father of two.
So Prabhu, also one point to add, unless it is already covered, is, you know, we go through the highs and lows of income sometimes. You know, sometimes the job is so good, we are making good money. Sometimes the job is okay, and sometimes there is no job, right? So I think there is a special account you can create, which is like a donation type of account, where when you are surplus, you can put money over there. So you can take the tax rebate, okay? And then you can claim it. Basically, you can do that donation over a period of time. So if anybody's in business and all that, and they're suddenly seeing highs and lows of income, then for donation continuity, it's possible to create a donation account with the bank. And when you put money into that account, you get the tax rebate as if you donated. Now you can decide after that where and how, at what frequency you want to deliver that money.
I know that. Actually, Fidelity has... It's called a charitable account, yeah, for highs and lows of income. And then tax-free, you are putting it there. And one of my godbrothers in Dallas, he does that. He puts money in there. And this year, he gave a donation of $50,000 to my Guru Maharaj this year. He's establishing a community in Srikakulam. Near Vishakhapatnam. So I was like amazed. I said, where did you get all this money? He said, every year I am putting some money aside and I have this 50,000. And then Guru Maharaj said, we should all invest in farms, Varnashrama. So he just pulled out a check just like that without blinking. When everybody else is crying due to Corona, he wrote a $50,000 check.
Yeah, that's the benefit of planning. Yeah.
Because he planned, right? Like, he's been in America for like 17 years and he has planned. Whereas some of us don't really plan that much. Mm-hmm. Okay, any other thoughts? I know there are a lot of people. Come on. Use your intelligence in this for collective good. Rakesh Bhai, do you have any ideas?
There's like very nice ideas already here, Roji. Let me think. I'll share.
Okay, that's good. Let's move on. Okay. So, what is life of a devotee? Life of a devotee wants to follow Srila Prabhupada, faces a number of hurdles in living a modern life, right? Each one of us is very familiar with this stuff. I do not have time for my rounds. My consciousness is not getting pure. I do not have nutrients for eating. I'm growing old prematurely. Like, because, you know, my grandfather used to lift like 50 pounds, 70 pounds when he was 80 years old. And today I was in the backyard doing my backyard farming. And to even lift flower pots is becoming a challenge for me. What's wrong with this picture, right? I do not know if the food that I'm eating is safe for me. I cannot handle modern day demands. Kids are addicted to video games. Not sure if mainstream devotees or part-time devotee like me, right? We are all part-time devotees. Let's face it, right? We are not, full-time devotees. So do we want our kids to be brahmacharis and become like all the nice brahmacharis who visit us? Or are we content with them being just like us, right? And this is my statement. I'm not sure about you, but pretty sure I'm not going back to Godhead on the current trajectory. I have to do something about my life. So this is not about financial management. This is more about life management, right? How are we going to change our life so that we can go back to Godhead? Because the formula is there. Prabhupada already established the formula. Formula is not difficult. But our practice of that formula requires a lot of correction, right? Because if we just TK attitude we'll have, and one fine day there'll be knock on the door and we'll have to go, right? So here are our challenges for a modern life. Let me now go to the next slide. This is again related to where our money is, right? Most of us have money in the so-called stock market. And I'm doing a lot of research because I have too much free time these days, right? Because Corona, even temple is closed. So I've been doing a lot of research. So all our supply chains are mangled and traditional consumers are losing their jobs. America's stock market was always a mirage and it will continue to be a mirage. And it is dissolving right in front of us. And it is dangerous for us to hope that it will reappear. Because it's a distraction from the real world. Real world means the economy. Stock market is just a layer on top of the economy. Just like, you know, a factory produces goods, but a retailer is just a layer on top. He's just selling that good, but he's not really producing the good. Same thing. Stock market is just a layer on top of. Okay. So, and why a lot of economists in America are worried right now is American productivity, which is the most important factor in increasing well-being, has been growing quite slowly. The stock market has been careening further and further out of whack. Real economy graph is a slope of 10 degrees and stock market graph is at a slope of 20-25 degrees. You understand the concept of slope, right? Rise over run. Rise means how high it is going. Run means how long it is going. Okay, now I have to start muting people. How do I mute everyone? Oh, there is no option to mute everyone. Interesting. Okay, please go on.
Did you log in as admin, Prabhuji?
Huh?
Did you log in as admin?
I have no idea. I just clicked on a link, sir.
Okay, this is your Zoom, right, Prabhuji?
Yeah, this is Zoom. This is your Zoom. So okay. You can log in as admin and mute everyone. And then you can unmute when there is a question.
Okay, Prabhuji.
Okay. Anyway, let's keep going. The time is of essence.
Sorry, Prabhu. Something was cooking at home.
No, I'm not logged in as host. I'm logged in.
Yeah, that's why you can mute everybody.
Okay. So American productivity is going at a very slow pace, right? We are not really producing anything grand. Like if you look at Intel chip, AMD chip, the whole PC, Windows, all these things were developed 20 years ago, right? Aeroplane like 737, 747, 757, all of these things were developed 20 years ago. 737, believe it or not, was developed 49 years ago, right? So there's not been any substantial innovation. And what governments are doing is they're printing money. It is called quantitative easing. So they're printing money to just put more cash in circulation so that there is a bubble. It makes everybody feel good. That's it. See, when you are making 70K, house was $300,000. Now you are making 140K, house is $800,000 or $900,000. So net, you actually became poor. You see my point? When you are making 70K, you could easily afford a $300,000 home. When you are making 140K, it is difficult for you to afford a 900K home. So we are building bubbles, housing bubble, dot-com bubble before that. And now with this worldwide pandemic we face, we are going to experience something akin to war. It's like a war, right? It's just the invisible enemy. During war, what happens? First casualties. What is the first casualty in war? Anybody know? Come on, you didn't need any novels like Aldous Huxley. Nobody read any novels here? First casualty in war is truth. So you don't know who to trust anymore. So truth is the first casualty in any war. So right now, we don't know what's going on. Somebody says Andre Fauci is being asked to leave. somebody says, no, he's not being asked to leave. So who knows what's going on? And he is the infectious disease chief for our country. And if he himself, his position is not safe, which means we don't know what the real facts are. You see the point? So you have to be very careful in what you hear and what is being given to us like that. Okay. So why keeping your money, your 401k money in stock market is gambling? So I took out my money from 401k from stock market almost 10 years ago and put it all in bonds or cash equivalents. And there is a reason I do that, because you may think market is good, but if you actually look at your growth pattern, you'll only see 2% or 3% growth. And there is a reason for that. So short sellers, what they do, they buy stock to cover short sales. So short sale means you don't have stock, but you buy stock. You just say with a promise that, Are Baba, I'll give you money tomorrow. Let me buy some stock. Before tomorrow, they hope to sell it off and make like 2 or 3 cents on every dollar, and then pay the guy some interest who gave them loan and pocket the difference. So real stock market is not investment. It is short selling and short buying. So what happens? Once the short sales happen, stock market rise, and then the Momo crowd jumps in, momentum crowd. Momentum crowd means if some stock has momentum, like today Netflix rose by 7%. It takes a year for a stock to grow 7%. It went up in 7% in one day. How do you believe that, right? It is Momo, means momentum. And then buy signals are given. So you have these artificial intelligence algorithms that will say, okay, there's too much momentum on this stock. So now it has become a buy. So a junk stock suddenly becomes a buy stock. And then technical oriented traders will jump in at that point. So technicals means they'll say, oh, this stock has done pretty good last week, which means it is in a good buy zone. So they will buy in. Then FOMO crowd gets in, fear of missing out. F for fear, O is for off, M for missing, O is for out. So when FOMO crowd starts buying, what happens? Mom and pop investors like you and me get in. We think, Are Baba, it's a time to make some money. That's it. And a few days later, short sellers sell everything in anticipation of a drop. Hup, lost money. So when you are in 401k, when you are investing through your company invests at this peak and there is a drop after that. Again, it invests because these are like monthly cycles. Right? So you are buying high, but your value of your stock is actually lower than what you bought it for. Because you are thinking, Are, I'm just investing every month here. I'm putting money in my bank. Right? So the average person thinks that I am investing. I am working very hard, working for a corporation. I'm investing my money. But they are purchasing stock in the stock market at a higher price. So that's why right here, you are screwed when your 401k money is invested at these peaks. Because when you go to a peak, what will happen? The next thing is a drop. Right? That's why for the last 10 years, I have not invested in the stock market. Because what you invested 10 years ago has appreciated, but what you invested last month, you have actually lost money on it. So net average, if you look, you're getting 2 to 3% return on investment over a 10-year horizon. Right? Technically, if you look at from December or November 2019 to now, the stock market has been relatively flat. It has gone up many times, but if you look at it, last 1 year return is practically zero, if not negative. And also this is assuming that you are invested in good stocks. What if, your 401k administrator screwed up and invested in some faltu stock? So you actually end up losing money, not gaining money, right? So that creates an illusion. Actually, there was a very beautiful article written a few years ago where they say, without 401k, America will not move forward. They need your money. So they take your money and then they invest it in various other things. So be very careful. I don't have a clear answer because nobody has a clear answer. Somebody asked Warren Buffett, where do you think the market will go? Warren Buffett said it will fall by 50%. And people said, what, Warren? How can you make such a bad statement? He said, nobody knows. Do you think I know? He's a disciplined investor, slightly better than rest of us. But actually, nobody knows. So I'll pause there for any thoughts.
Sorry. I joined a little late.
Yeah, go ahead, Sanjay.
So what's your suggestion on investing then? If you say we can't invest in stocks.
Buy land. I already covered that. Maybe you were a little late. मैंने बोला था यहाँ पे कि golden era of stocks is behind us. Buy land. The next battle is for arable land, means where crops can be grown.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. I gave an example of Guntur in Andhra Pradesh. One acre of land that produces good quality rice is 3 crore rupees in Guntur. 3 crore is like what, 425 or 450,000 US dollars. I don't think any one of us has that much spare cash even. आपके पूरे पैसे लेकर आप इंडिया जाओगे ना तो एक एकड़ नहीं खरीद पाओगे.
I mean, even land is also overvalued. It's not that really.
No, but you should buy where it is not overvalued, right? Like, you know, I saw land in Enumclaw, 10 acres for 890K. So that's only 89K. But if you go to South Carolina, land is only $4,000 per acre.
I mean, everything is demand and supply, Prabhu. If there is...
So go and buy where it is cheap, right? Who said that we have to compete with the very rich guys? Here, with you are competing with the Amazon guys, $2,000 per stock, right? The guy has to sell 10 stocks, he gets $20,000. How are you going to compete with that guy? No way. This city is out of our reach right now. I mean, we have to go to Enumclaw or Olympia. Their stuff is cheap. Or go to East Coast, like that.
I mean, so these are all assets, right? I mean, land is one asset, stocks, everything is an asset. And I mean, it requires you to manage it. You know, not everything is easy. Generally, stocks, you can easily, through some basic technical analysis and see, you know, how the trend is. And you can exit quicker than the rest of the other things, other assets. I mean, you need to have a little bit of technical analysis.
How many people, 26 people on the call, how many of us have that expertise?
Right? Yeah, I mean, but over the long term, always stocks grow. If you see over the period of 5 years or the span of 5 to 10 years, it's better to have in, you know, growing.
Now comes
this. Anything is an asset.
No, I agree with you. Now the philosophical aspect I want to introduce right now. When they invest your stock in a slaughterhouse or in alcohol companies, or in, for that matter, even petroleum companies where they are abusing Mother Earth, then you are getting negative karma. You cannot avoid that. Prabhupada said that in many places. Demonic civilization where they are basically raping Mother Earth.
Oh, yeah. So that problem exists. That problem exists with everything, bro. You buy a land from a, you don't know who the land.
No, but land doesn't belong to anybody.
It's the same problem.
This property. Land belongs to Krishna, right? We are like the guy is selling to you. You may sell it to somebody else. Nobody owns land. We are just purveyors of the land. We just hold it for some time, and then you pass it on to the next guy, right? See, the land where my house is, where I'm sitting and giving the, you know, participating in this discussion, belongs to who? It belonged to American Indians 80 years ago. Prior to that, I mean, actually, Westerners about 80 years ago. Prior to that, American Indians. Prior to that, who knows who, right? So we never own land. We just have purveyorship. So, but land is concrete, right? Land is concrete. Stocks are not concrete. You know, you probably have not heard this.
Yeah, that is
called Enron. Enron stock was $60. This was 15 years ago. I was very much into stocks in those days. It fell to $3 from $60 because the guys did some hera-fera accounting and everything came down, right? Yeah, you're looking at average, but there is also karmic consequence of investing in the stock market. It's debatable, right? I mean, you are a devotee, so you know the philosophy too. But this is my viewpoint.
Prabhuji, one more point on that. Prabhuji, if you are in a stock, if today if you have $100, you can just put it in $100 for that. But if you want to buy a land, you have to have at least $10,000 for the land you speak, talking about South Carolina even to buy. So there's a difference. The penny investment and starting with maybe penny or daily investment or buying a land is a huge amount.
Yeah. So very good point. But there you can grow crops and eat. You cannot eat stocks, right? I mean, stocks you have to sell to get the money. And sometimes money cannot buy stuff. Like today, you cannot buy many stuffs in COVID America, right? Like I went to Amazon. A 15-pound bag of brown rice, Nishiki brown rice, is $69.95. Just 3 weeks ago in Costco, 15 pounds was sold for $12.50. So they jacked up the price, right? So you are at the mercy of somebody all the time. Again, you know, there's no clear dark and black and white, right? So if you can do more with land than you can do a lot more with stocks. Stocks is liquid, yes, I agree. But it is rapidly depreciating also sometimes.
I mean, yeah, we have to be careful. When you invest anything, you have to be careful. It's the same with, whether it is land or whether it is stocks. Doesn't matter. I mean, you are buying from Amazon means you are contributing. Whether you buy through stocks or you buy through, their shopping cart, doesn't matter. I mean, we are part of this society. What we can, as an earner, whatever you earn, as long as you utilize that properly, which is within your, within your grip or hands. I think that is how we can do. We can deal here.
But then
we cannot say.
Then what is the difference between Prabhupada Anugas and the general population? General population is also doing those things, right? So we have to.
Yeah. So general population.
Philosophy altogether, don't we?
No.
I'm just posing a counter argument. That's all.
Yeah. I mean, there is definitely. So the way you use money versus a general outsider who doesn't know about, any philosophy is very different. It's after it comes to you, how do you use that matters, right? You don't control how, as a part of a society, how your overall assets fare, that you cannot control. Because in any way, you are contributing to Amazon, you are contributing to whatever, internet. So we cannot say, oh, this is bad, that is good. That way it doesn't work out because we are part of the society. What you can control is what is within your hand. I would say that.
Yeah. So Bhakti Charu Maharaj, he came about 10 years ago and he gave a class at my home. I was very lucky to host him. He said, this society is sinful. We should break the backbone of this society. And now you may think, oh, how can we do that? We are only 10 people here. But that is the goal, right? If you create an alternate society, international society for Krishna consciousness, it's not violence or anything, right? It is like you create an alternate society which will promote mode of goodness. I mean, these are not my statements. Bhakti Charu Maharaj, who is international GVC, right? I mean, he's GVC for our temple also. So some very higher up people are making these higher up statements.
Definitely, we should do that as much as we can.
As much,
but
yeah.
We cannot abruptly change.
So you can abruptly, it is not possible. It may take 300 years, 500 years, but it's already changing. Like, on my LinkedIn, I published a article, not published, reshared a post about an eco village in Tennessee. These guys don't even know who Krishna is. They don't even follow Jesus or anything like that. But they said, we need to be good land stewards. So these people quit their jobs. They went and started living on a farm community. And they are doing exactly what Govardhan Eco Village does or what the Alachua farm does, which is amazing. I thought it was very amazing. They are non-spiritual, but they are trying to do exactly what Prabhupada recommended. Because they're saying, we are sick and tired of this. Sick and tired of this modern, cheating. Because in cheating means what? Money is only exchanging hands, right? So you work for a corporation, you get some money, you're giving it to somebody. It's just rotation. Money is just getting rotated without increasing happiness index.
So, this is Ramakundas. I have one comment, Prabhu. So this all this recent discussion, this started with the different avenues of investment, if not stock. So one suggestion is land. Second suggestion is stock, which is debatable. And third, I was thinking gold. How about investing in gold, like buying gold?
Yeah, so Prabhupada said that every man should provide gold for his wife because that gives the women confidence that we are secure, right? Gold for women.
I think, Prabhu, we need to discuss in more detail, like, you know, how we can buy gold, whether it is in terms of biscuits or is it terms of, you know, jewelry or... How to, and also the other point which Gupta Prabhu made is important about liquidity. You know, this gold, you know, to answer his question, with $100 we can buy gold. You know, you can liquidate that also pretty quickly.
Gold minimum you can buy is
to land. Yeah.
Gold minimum you can buy one coin. Right now, market rate is around $1,600 for one, like a US mint gold coin. So even there, you cannot buy anything for $100, right? The minimum thing you can buy is $1,600, right? So, I mean, that's not a bad idea. So Prabhupada always favored gold and land versus the speculative instruments. That's why he said no gambling very clearly. Stock market is gambling. You see the ups and downs. Because I'm an avid follower, right? I'm a student of the stock market, since my financial days in college. 1995, I took financial engineering course at University of Alabama. So, you know, I've been into options and puts and calls and financial instruments very, very deep way. So I'm a student of that. So I know how things play out, right? So, but your point is good. Maybe gold is one other avenue. Maybe there are other avenues. Let's see what else. Invest in the holy name. That is an even bigger investment. If you invest in the holy name, when everybody else was dying in Bengal famine, the Vaishnavas had very low death rate. Harulas Maharaj was saying once in his class, this was right after the Spanish flu, there was a Bengal famine, 1920. So a lot of people died, 2 lakh people died, but Vaishnavas in Bengal didn't die. And somehow or the other they managed. How did they manage? Because they invested in the holy name. So you can invest in gold, you can invest in the holy name. There are various kinds of investments that we can make.
Prabhuji, one question, Prabhuji.
Yes, sir.
Jaipal here. So is any investment is considered as a gambling? Isn't considered as gambling? Because we are investing hoping that it's going to go up. Whether it is land or gold.
No. It's like this, right? Land prices will go up because population will increase and therefore there'll be more people willing to pay for it. That's not speculative because you are actually using the land to grow crops. You are living on it. But whereas with a stock to a certain degree with gold, you are buying it exclusively only for appreciation. Then lova sets in, right? Karma.
No, then it's not considered as investment, right, Prabhuji? If you are buying land for your growing crops, that's good. But I don't know how many of us will grow crops in the land we buy.
You will. I'll tell you when you will. When the economy loses its momentum, a lot of people in America actually go to land. And Srila Prabhupada also himself said that we need to have farm communities because Americans will come in millions to our farms, right? It's called the back to farms movement. And in a certain way, COVID has actually encouraging some people to kind of get out of this rat race and come into that type of environment, actually. Like if you look at Cody, right? You know Cody, the white boy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you talk to him. He's fed up with this American way of life. He wants to live on a farm. That's it, period. There is one other gentleman, San Diego temple president, who came to our temple and gave a class years ago. He took a job and is now living on land. Investment farm, some devotees made there. And again, I have slides on various farm communities that are coming up in various parts of United States. Because what happens is, I'm not talking about land as a gambling investment. Land as a place for survival, right? You go there, you live there in a simple living environment. There, you don't even need to buy so much stock, or you don't even need so much cash, because we are predicating our thinking that everything has to be the same way. And it's already proven, like 16 million people have applied for unemployment, right? Because of COVID-19. Now they don't have land. What are they going to eat? Like one lady in Chicago was saying, I had $800. I paid April rent, my dear landlord. I don't have money to pay your May rent. She already announced to her landlord. That's it. Jo karna hai kar le. I don't have money to pay your May rent. This is the last rent I'm going to give you. Right? So this is bound to happen, because capitalism, what happens is, if there are 10 employees, 10 employees are working for, say, $1,000 a month, 10,000. The boss has to sell at least 20,000 worth of goods to pay them 10,000. So therefore, all effort of individuals will coagulate with a few people's hands. Like if you see, Amazon stock went up from, like, you know, I used to keep track of it since 1995 or 6, I believe. When it was like $25 or $26. Now it is $2,000, right? It didn't split ever. So who became rich? Only one guy became very rich, Bezos, right? I asked many employees in the temple, I say, "Arey, aap log Amazon mein kaam karte ho, thoda donation do." And then, you know what those fellows say? "I only have 10 stock. All the stock is with big boss, Bezos," right? Most of the low-level employees don't have anything. So capitalism by its intrinsic nature will make a few people rich. That's it. You cannot argue with it, right? Same thing with Microsoft. Lot of employees are working very hard. Only a few people at the top will become rich. So some people are sick and tired of that model. And if you don't want to be sick and tired of that, that's totally okay, right? I mean, as long as you have a job. But when things go south, then you need alternate sources of living, eating primarily. Food will be the next frontier. It is not so much stock or cash. Even cash might become meaningless. Like some of the South American countries have 1,000% inflation. You know what it means? So your money is to be divided by three zeros next year. There are some countries, Chile is one of them. Do some research, Google it. In Chile, they are having a lot of problems right now.
This is because
you cannot solve every problem, but I'm just laying out what the structure of the world is, right? From a financial perspective. And then you should make your own decisions.
So Prabhu, I had this question, right? Like, you know, if you're saying we have to buy land in Enumclaw or Auburn, but like, you know, this Washington state here, for a good part of the year, we can't grow anything. And if it comes to that, and okay, we can't survive without land, then is it good or advisable to even invest in this area?
Yeah, so then you have to now think, right? This is a broad portfolio. You have options of, you know, South India, some crops grow, North India, some crops grow, California, some crops grow, Washington. Actually, it's not like you cannot grow. You can grow broccoli, you can grow cabbage, asparagus. You can grow quite a few things in Washington is the world's apple capital, right? This is where all the world's apple comes from. Even Hyderabad, they are selling Washington apples. I actually saw that, right? So some crops will grow here. Not everything will grow everywhere. And again, this is to stimulate our thinking, right? It's not like tomorrow you'll go and buy land. But that is where the focus is shifting to. I mean, food is the most important. Other things can wait. If there is no food, then we'll be in trouble. Right now, we are not getting the same vegetables that we got 3 weeks ago. We are, you know, Jaipal got us some cauliflower and tomatoes from Cash and Carry. We are living on that right now. Previously, we used to eat with so many different vegetables. Supply come out, yeah, na?
Yeah, no, so bro, what I'm saying is like, you know, if the situation comes like that, then why should we stay in US? Like, you know, isn't it good to go back to India in that case?
Exactly. I cannot make your decision for you, right? I'm just laying out the facts. So if you go to India, then you need to have a plan there. What are you going to do there? Ultimately, in order for you to be devotional, you have to figure out what is the plan A, plan B, plan C, like that. Right. So some people have actually gone back, like Vedanarayan Prabhu. He went back he had two homes here. He had, like, after selling the homes, maybe 300K or something. So he built 20 flats. Each flat he rents for 5,000 rupees a month. And he uses that money and he doesn't work. What does he do? Morning till evening, he goes to school, conducts classes on Bhagavad Gita. And his life is set now. He's in a much better position than any one of us.
Yeah, meaning we have to see what our priorities are, like, individually.
Yeah, our priorities are actually screwed up right now. That's what I'm saying. We are thinking that, you know, America will save us. Somehow or the other, we'll continue this inflated lifestyle forever. This lifestyle is inflated, believe me. I came in 1994 to America and we never used to have so much. I used to have a whole 1997 Honda Accord, and I would, 87 Honda Accord. I bought it for 5,000. I drove it for like 3 years. We used to have a very simple life in America also. So all this artificial wealth that has come is already, you know, losing steam right now. Like, if COVID continues for 6 or 8 more months, my brother is in Regions Bank, I was saying, he was saying that it will take 5 years to recover if it continues for 6 more months. The economy is what is economy? I sell you sell me. But if you don't even leave home, if I'm not producing anything, you're not producing anything, economy has to tank, right? And I never imagined in my life such a thing would happen. I used to always think, "Arey, just like housing crisis came, there'll be some bank issues or something." But here, this is both supply shock and demand shock. Supply shock means goods are not being produced. And demand shock means there's nobody willing to buy goods also right now. So this is a dual whammy.
So Prabhu, one thing I'll say, like, you know, before this talk, I was thinking still things were okay. But after this, like, I feel more depression. Like, you know,
I'm more worried. The goal is not to depress you. The goal is to... Like, I published a paper on my LinkedIn recently where John Schwartz, one of the guys, says, "Wake up, America." And he says how America is in a deep slumber. Mujhe to pehli baat to yaad aayi Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki. Jeev jago, Gora Chand bole. It's exactly similar to what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying. Wake up, your soul. Kitne der ye maya ke lap mein sote rahega tu. Right? So that John Schwartz was saying that America is sleeping right now. We have to wake up. We have built this artificial edifice structure based on artificial cash by printing more money. Right? But what is most important? Roti, kapda and makan. Ye teen nahi honge to fir kya kar loge aap? So first secure these three things. Right? First is our roti. We have to secure that. Everything else will come later.
Bro, what do you think about our jobs? do you think we should give up the jobs also now? Next thing.
No.
Meaning what I'm thinking, like, you know, if these kind of things keep happening, like, you know, okay, if this continues, like, you know, we are in IT, we are able to work from home. But if other people are not able to get back to job, what would happen to us?
No, like, what they will do is, when people don't spend money, right, initially, like, Microsoft has cash for next 10 years. So initially everything will be rosy, but then Wall Street will put pressure on Microsoft. They'll say, "Hey, show me some return on investment." Then Satya has to get rid of some people now. It is not automatic. You know, our worldwide CEO ne meeting mein aaya tha. Okay, I'll talk in English because there are some other language people. So when our worldwide CEO came to a meeting, he said, let me present the facts straight. The pie is shrinking. He didn't say I'll lay you off. He said, the pie is shrinking. Samajhte ho na? Like the pie. Like suppose you have a pie where you make 8 slices and you eat it. But if the pie becomes half the size, instead of getting 8 slices, you'll only get 4 slices, which means half the number of people will not have jobs. We'll pray to Krishna that doesn't happen. But, you know, these are very senior people, much senior than me and much more smarter than me are making these statements.
Narekshya Prabhu. So Prabhu, this is a very interesting discussion and I see you have 31 slides to go. So are we like kind of limiting it every day 1 hour? And I heard like you're going to continue every day. So
that is the plan. Yeah. So it is 8 o'clock. In it depends on how long you want to go. Otherwise we can continue it tomorrow. What do you say?
My preference is Prabhu, let's do it, you know, 1 hour every day so that, you know, we can balance it out.
Sustainable.
Yeah.
I think we can do some brainstorming again. We can come up with the questions for tomorrow, Prabhu, based on the slide.
Yeah, this is a collective exercise, right? I don't have all the answers. So we are for how many people on the call? 26 people. So everybody has some ideas, right? How to overcome this, Armageddon, the situation that's happening right now.
Prabhuji, would you like to share the PowerPoint?
After the sessions, not immediately.
Okay. I'm thinking you can host it on the temple SharePoint or something and send a link so that it's not really the file, it's the link to the file. So as we brainstorm and you keep updating, we always have the latest to fall back on.
Yeah. So do you have do you know where to post it, temple SharePoint?
Jaipal Prabhu, how we do the device recruitment Excel sheets on SharePoint of temple?
Yeah, sure, Prabhuji. Send the file to me, Prabhuji. I can post it and share you the link. Share back to you.
Okay. No, but I don't want people to like read the PowerPoint and then stop coming to the.
Right.
That's what happens at Microsoft, and that will happen here also.
Yeah, Prabhu, thank you, Prabhu, for putting this together and sharing your experience.
It's really useful, Prabhuji.
And we promise to come even if you share the PowerPoint.
Okay.
Yeah, Prabhu, this is an interesting discussion here. You know, all the devotees are giving input.
Yeah. Okay. See you all next week then. Thank you. Hare
Krishna. Next week or
every day, Prabhu. Every day, right?
Tomorrow.
Every day.
Okay, Hare tomorrow Hare. 7 o'clock.
Tomorrow 7 a.m. Right, Prabhuji? Okay.
7 p.m.
7 p.m. Sorry.
Okay. So tomorrow, let us know how many people are selling their stocks and all. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.